First the train from London to Liverpool, then a short trip to the docks where I boarded the ferry to Dublin, then the long train ride through Ireland to Belfast. Not a bad ride, but excruciatingly long. Check in at the guest house in the town proper, quick supper, quick sleep, quick breakfast, and a hop on the local train here to the Holland & Wolff shipyard. Fortunately, it was punctual. I was worried about being tardy for being 3 hours early. My darling Claire always said to me, "Robin, you better get out of the house right now and go be useful for someone." She always did lovingly encourage me to show up for work early and give my best effort. Titanic is likely no different from the Olympic. They're structurally identical. The Olympic underwent these trials months ago, so this should be a simple repeat. I board, observe her during the sea trials, vote aye or nay on her certification, and then I ride her back to Southampton. "Come on, Robin, you can't mess this one up," as Claire always told me. Let's look at the positive. The weather broke, and now I've been given the opportunity to board the Titanic Advance of the Trials. This gives me a bit of time to really admire the beauty of the ship before I have to scrutinize every last aspect of her functionality. I had better find my way aboard. But I suppose there isn't reason for too much haste. No one else has even arrived yet, it seems. Plenty of time to explore, if I desire. I'm quite surprised by the amount of confidence the industry is placing into this ship. She's not even certified yet, and her first ticketed voyage is just a week from now. No room for failure on these trials, I suppose. It's like getting dressed up for a date when you haven't even begun your courtship yet. How do you know if you'll be rejected or not? I learned that one the hard way. Belfast Lock is beautiful. With the hills around it and the morning fog, it reminds me of what I always imagined Puget Sound would be like. A man sure can make a living out in Seattle, if he can hold off the plague. Reminds me of my childhood in Sheffield. I see they're doing all they can to extend my travel time. How do I find my way through this mess? So close to the aft gangway. They couldn't simply move these signs out of the way. This vessel has triple screws. Yes, I feel the same way right now too, thank you. Thank you. What in damnation? They couldn't lay out this train yard any better? You just can't beat that train carriage arrangement. It really stretched my cognitive abilities. People simply aren't stimulated enough these days. Claire tells me that every night. Since the aft gangway is blocked, I'll board here through the first class. Most first-class spaces should be accessible at the moment, but I may be able to venture down to third class for a spell through Scotland Road on E-Deck. I believe I'm boarding before anyone else. Robin, right now you're the most handsome man on the Titanic. I especially commend them for modifying the bulkhead. I never cared much for what was on the Olympic. I see many of the tables are already set. There will be a fine banquet here for company and partner representatives, myself included, along with the one and only paying passenger joining us on our way to Southampton this evening. I'd hate to be quartered back here in such a cramped cubby, the walls bearing down on you like all the troubles, hopes, and deepest desires you dare not dwell upon. A nice Arabian motif with cooling colors as passengers relax after their time in the baths. But what a poor state these workers left it in. Who on earth is that lucky dog testing out the electric bath? And I believe I see a sliver of the plunge bath as well. This is glorious. You can near well see half the length of the ship in this corridor. This open space looks like a fine spot for gathering and mingling between all parts of Europe as they make their journey across the pond to the New World. Perhaps a place on the West Coast, like Seattle. Oh dear, the door is open. Perhaps I'm not supposed to look in here, but I can't pass up this opportunity for a little adventure. Oh, if Claire were here now to see me being so daring. How by Edward did I get myself here? Climbing too high, I think. No, Robin, it's not your time to get your angel wings just yet. No, not just yet. It's quite hot here. Where are the workers, though? Well, I suppose they're likely firing up the other boiler room. These machines are massive. 29 on board, propelling the ship through the water like an untamed beast. I anxiously await their performance during the sea trial shortly. Finally free and not held back from anything. No Mr. Tundry in sight. Just freedom. On down to the food stores, crew compartments, and stern of the ship. No need to go this way. A stark contrast from the first-class accommodations, I should say, but still a major improvement from the other liners I've inspected. In all honesty, I envy these people in the lower class. The world is open to them. They move to America and build their future how they choose. They could be loggers, for example. But Father wanted me to be a surveyor like he and his father. No logging for you, Robin. Now wash your ears. The lifts are out of order. That's fine. Real men don't take lifts. Lifts are for women, Claire says. Robin, take the long way up. Soon this area will be bustling with passengers anxiously sending telegrams and complaining about the most trivial of matters. I consider it a blessing that I will not be around to witness that. I shouldn't venture too far on deck. The Board of Trade members may board soon, and I'm expected to meet them. Cabins upon cabins. Thank you. love the word detailing here. It's absolutely perplexing. Now that's a craft I can really respect. Lovely wood. I've always been fond of wood. When younger, I used to cut wood for the poor folks two streets over. My neighbors started calling me Robin Wood. They always laughed, but I don't know why. I wore that title proudly. It really does remind you of Paris, though excepting the smell of overflown sewage. Wonderful memories are coming back to me of that city. Odd that this room would have its tables already set. Mr. Gotti hasn't even boarded yet. Oh well, top marks for presentation. What a fine accommodation for the unwinding of the gentlemanly sort after a long day at sea. If only it were open now, and there were men in there to socialize with, perhaps then I'd make some friends. I suppose this won't be open anytime soon. A shame. I would enjoy nothing more than a cup of tea and to sit with a book in the lounge and, well, lounge. I see Tommy Andrews is already on board. Why does this surprise me? His drawings are scattered about like toys in a nursery. Well, I shouldn't intrude here any longer. I wonder if the barber will be on board for the run to Southampton. Lord knows I should fancy a shave after my journey here. Speaking of barbers, I'm quite glad old Harry is there to look after Claire while I'm away. They always were fond of each other, and when my son was born, Harry was particularly fond of him, never missing a birthday. See, this is the kind of friend a man really needs. His presence seems to even alleviate her hysteria condition.